Christian.
Lord God, our church awaits our Savior, coming to scatter this moment's darkness and bring us your hope, love, and reassurance. Bless us as we light these candles. May they reflect the light and splendor of Christ with us forever. I'd like to welcome all of you to Mass this evening, especially those who are seeing us on the streaming. We come together as a congregation of faith, expressing our love for God. Let us pray. Grant your faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds at his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, they may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father, our Redeemer, you are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so that we fear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribes of your heritage. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down with the mountains quaking before you, while you wrought awesome deeds we could not hope for, such as they had not heard of from old. No ear has ever heard, no eye ever seen, any God but you doing such deeds for those who wait for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry, and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All of our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There's none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to you. For you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father, We are the clay and you the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord. Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you were enriched in every way, with all discourse and all knowledge, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of the Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you were called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Today the reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his own work, and orders the gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore. You do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all, watch." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Our time of Advent is a season of joy. It's a season of hope. But as we all know in the world today, it's very difficult with all the challenges to find hope with our pandemic and all the difficulties that it causes. So this evening, I'd like to share with you a story that gave me a little hope and reflect upon today's scripture, and hopefully we might find together how we, as people of God, as disciples, as God's people, may bring hope to our world. There was once a guy who worked in a factory, and he had a specialized thing to do, skilled worker, and he was there like for 20 years, and he was assigned an employee that they just hired to learn the skills that he knew. And they got together the first week and discussed everything. And after being together for a week, the guy's the mentor said to the new trainee, "You know, how about this weekend? We could get together, and my son is on the Little League team. We could watch the game, and after we watch the game, maybe we can go out and have a couple brewskis or beer, right?" So he said, "Sure, let's do it." Well, it was the weekend, Saturday evening, and the trainee was a little late in getting to the game. So he sat down next to his friend. He looked at the field and said, "How's it going?" "Oh, it's going real great." "Well, what's the score?" 18-0. Well, the guy said, "Well, that doesn't sound too good. Who's winning?" "The other team." "Well, that doesn't sound good at all." He says, "No, don't worry about that. It's only the first inning, and we haven't been up to bat yet." That's a story of a lot of hope, right? How they could possibly win the game. And I think that that's what the season of Advent, God calls us, the church, the season of Advent calls us to look at the situations of life and see the hope and joy that is there, to be alert, watchful for those joyful moments in life. And we celebrate that cycle of Advent and Christmas of the holy people of Israel going for years and years of slavery and waiting for a Savior to come. And in their darkness, or in the world, God comes down from heaven, rends the heavens, like in today's scripture reading from Isaiah, opens the heavens, and comes down and collides with humanity. The divine collides with humanity. And there's a great eruption that takes place, and that's our Lord Jesus Christ coming into the world. So I think that in our lives, we can reflect upon what are the things that have us down. And I'm sure all of us can make a lot of lists. Every time we listen to the news, we see the oppression of governments, allowing slavery and injustice. We see all the time of poverty and hunger in the world. We see in our own country injustices that take place, violence. And also in our own lives and family, maybe those people who might get the big C on their head, you know what that is? Cancer. A person in your family who might have a terminal disease, your time is limited, or maybe yourself might have been given that diagnosis. And in those extreme situations, you have to find the joy of life. Trying to work out your budget can be a constraint. Addiction, isolation, all the different calamities that could happen. And in some way, we are asked to gather together and to share the joy that comes through God for our salvation, telling us that whatever our difficulty is, that we are loved and cared for by a loving God who sent his Son to redeem our world. So I think that this great feeling of joy that we get during the Advent season is something that should be shared beyond our church, wherever we go. That we must see that even in the difficult times of life, that God is still present and still walks with us and journeys and helps us, supports us through the faith that we have been given, through the faith that we celebrate in this Holy Eucharist, through the support that we give to one another, especially families and friends and those in need. You know, a while back, if you remember, they said that the Cubs would never win a World Series, right? It was totally impossible. And look what happened. The Billy Goat did it, right? So I think that all of us should see, in whatever our trial might be, whatever the difficulties or challenges that we have in life, this season of Advent and Christmas touches all of us through our faith and gives us great joy. Just like the guy who was sort of depressed because his team was losing, and the other guy was there to spur him on and say, things are going to change, we are going to get better. We are called, as God's people, disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ. We are called to be agents of hope, joy, and peace in this world, especially at the time of this season of Advent and Christmas. May the hope and joy of the Lord always be with us, and may we always share it with everyone in this world. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, was buried, descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. There he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Father, our Redeemer forever, help us to walk by the light of your Son.
Our response is, transform us in your light. Fashion your church in holiness and integrity.
Transform us in your light.
Bring back those who have strayed from you. Transform us in your light. Shepherd our sick and burdened in your merciful care.
Transform us in your light.
Restore and heal our broken relationships.
Transform us in your light.
Inspire our faith community's treasure of our lives in you.
Transform us in your light.
Raise up those faithful among us who have returned home to you, remembering Virgil Pope and this day's intentions, Angela Burchetto, June Miloski, Helen Ozakowski, intentions of Peter and Tessie Wang, intentions of Milling and Carmen Chu.
Transform us in your life.
On the day of your Son's return, Lord, may he find us watchful and prepared, our hearts filled with wonder and gratitude, for he is our King and Savior forever and ever. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through our Lord Jesus Christ. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design that you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. So, saints and angels, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we now proclaim. In a similar way, on the same evening, he took the chalice of blessing in his hands. Celebrating, therefore, the memorial of the death and resurrection of your Son, who left us this pledge of his love, we offer you what you have bestowed on us, the sacrifice of perfect reconciliation. Holy Father, we humbly beseech you to accept us also together with your Son, and in this saving banquet, graciously to endow us with his very Spirit, takes away anything that estranges us from one another. May he make your church a sign of unity and an instrument of peace among your people, and may he keep us in communion with Francis, our Holy Father, Blaze, our Cardinal Archbishop, and all the bishops and your entire people. Just as you have gathered us now at the table of your Son, so also bring us together with the glorious Virgin Mary, Mother of God, your blessed Apostle, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints, with our sisters and brothers and those of every race and tongue who have died in your friendship. Bring us to share with them the unending banquet of unity in a new heaven and a new earth, where the fullness of your peace will shine forth in Christ Jesus our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we walk amid passing things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast in what endures. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for the blessing of God. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with his blessing. Amen. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with us forever.
Amen.
Please remember to share the joy of this season with others. Remember St. Eulalia's pantry that we support by your food items and financial donations. The Mass now is ended. Go in peace.